Hello friends, in this video we'll study about the Mediterranean climate, which is also known as warm temperate western margin climate or warm temperate west coast climate. This type of climate occurs only in the temperate regions and it occurs only on the western side of the continents. Under the Köppen scheme of classification, we have studied about few very important climatic types under tropical humid type of climates, where we have seen about these three types of climates. And then we have studied about the dry type of climates, where we have studied about desert, that is arid type of climate, as well as semi-arid type of climate. There we have studied about mid-latitude steppe, though it is a mid-latitude or temperate region climate, but still it is a semi-arid climate. So it is grouped under the dry type of climates, which is represented by alphabet B under Köppen scheme of classification. Now in this video, we'll begin with the warm temperate type of climatic regions, which is indicated by alphabet C. Here there are three important types. One is Mediterranean, other one is humid subtropical, which is also called as China type climate. And then we have marine west coast climate. This is called as British type climate. So here we can see the alphabet C, common for all. And we have other alphabets like F. F stands for wet type of climate, where there is no dry season. And the alphabet A stands for warm summers or hot summers. And S stands for dry summers. We have this type of conditions are typical to Mediterranean climate, where we have warm and dry summers and wet winters. So S stands for dry summers. And we have the British type of climate, which is also called as marine west coast climate. It is indicated by CFB. Here the temperatures are comparatively lower compared to the humid subtropical type of climate, and it is wet, where there is no dry season. So this is all about sea type of climates, and in today's video we study only about the Mediterranean type of climate. Coming to the distribution of Mediterranean type of climate, we can see from the map it is mainly concentrated in on the western side of the continents. For example, we have Swanland and other regions which are part of Australia, which are on the western side. And then we have the Mediterranean region. So typically we can consider this landform as the western part of Eurasian continental landmass. And we have parts of California, which is also present to the western on the western side of the continent. And we have central Chile, which is also a part of western side of the continents. So these are the typical regions where we see Mediterranean type of climate, but this type of climate is very well noted in the Mediterranean region, and hence the name Mediterranean type of climate. So it occurs mostly within 30 degrees and 45 degrees north and south of the equator. So after 22.5 degrees, we have temperate regions beyond Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn. We have temperate regions. Typically all these regions come under temperate climatic conditions. So this is where this type of climate is found, and it is affected by shifting wind belts. So in the previous videos on permanent pressure belts and wind systems, we have studied about the pressure belts, pressure systems and winds, that is easterlies, westerlies, etc. So these are affected by shifting of wind belts. We know that with the apparent movement of sun, usually based on seasons, we have wind belts shifting from north to south and south to north based on the movement of the sun. For example, if sun is moving from equator towards the Tropic of Cancer, in such a case the wind belts shift towards the north, and in the opposite case they shift towards the south. So Mediterranean climate is mainly formed because of this shifting wind belts. We'll see that in detail in the next slide. The most important factor with Mediterranean climate is the dry summers. This is unique and typical to only Mediterranean climate. We have no other climate where summers are dry, because most of the rainfall in other types of climates occurs mainly in summers, whereas winters are relatively dry or they see less amount of rainfall. Even in certain climates where there is winter maxima of rainfall, we still don't have summer dry summers. But in Mediterranean climate, we have rains only in winter season and the summers are totally dry. So we have seen that Mediterranean Sea has the greatest extent of this type of climate, and hence the name Mediterranean Sea. And these are the regions. So let us look how pressure systems and wind belts shift according to seasons. So in July, we have summer in the northern hemisphere, where sun's apparent path is along the Tropic of Cancer. In such a case, we have intertropical convergence zone, we can see in this path. So when we have intertropical convergence zone, which is a kind of thermal equator, which it is also called as thermal equator, then we have a subtropical high pressure belt somewhere along this line. So we can see the Mediterranean region, for example, this one, the parts of California and then parts of Chile. Sorry, we are considering only the northern hemisphere for the time being because it is summer in the northern hemisphere, whereas it is winter in the southern hemisphere during July. We can see high pressure belts are concentrated on these particular regions, both Mediterranean as well as Californian region. And we know that high pressure belts are associated with descending air, and hence there is no cloud formation. And as a result, the rainfall is low or completely absent during summer season due to the concentration of high pressure belt. Now in July in the southern hemisphere, we know that due to sun's apparent northward shift, we have the high pressure belt which has shifted somewhere to the north. And now if you see this particular region, that is central Chile and parts of Australia, are under the influence of westerlies. So westerlies are flowing in this direction. Typically it would be accurately this direction because of the Coriolis force. And when they flow in this direction, they carry good amount of moisture from the oceans, and when they hit the landmass, they drop this moisture in the form of rains. So in the winter, that is when it is in the month of July, it is winter in the southern hemisphere. As a result, there is good amount of rainfall in this particular region, that is central Chile, Swanland and parts of Australia. So all these regions see rainfall in the winter season, whereas the northern hemisphere, in the northern hemisphere, the regions of California and Mediterranean are under the influence of high pressure belts, and hence they are very, very dry in summer. So when the situation is reversed, that is in January, we have winter in the northern hemisphere and summer in the southern hemisphere. We can see that the high pressure belts, which were somewhere to the north, have shifted towards, particularly towards the southern region, and all these regions where we have Mediterranean type of climate are under the influence of high pressure belt. Because of this high pressure belt, there is no rainfall in the parts of Chile, that is the Mediterranean climatic region of Chile and parts southwestern parts of Australia. So when we consider the northern hemisphere, the high pressure belt has shifted to the south. So this is typically the high pressure belt. As a result, we can see now the westerlies are hitting the coast of California and the parts of Mediterranean region. So because of westerlies, these particular regions receive rainfall in winter, that is the northern hemispheric regions receive rainfall in winter, whereas it is summer in January in the southern hemisphere and it is totally dry. So this is about the Mediterranean climate, where winters have rainfall whereas summers are totally dry. So coming to the Mediterranean climate, the annual precipitation is very low compared to the humid tropical climatic regions, where the typical rainfall is between 200 to 250 centimeters. In dry, in tropical wet and dry, that is savanna type of climate, the rainfall is about 100 to 200 centimeters. But here in this region, we can see it closely suits semi-arid type of climatic conditions, where the rainfall is between 25 and 60 degrees, 60 centimeters. So here it is somewhere, the range is somewhere close. So it is somewhat similar to the semi-arid type of climate, with one major difference being the winters having rainfall, whereas summers being totally dry. So this is the typical annual rainfall, which is, when compared to other regions, it is very, very low. And coming to the warmest month, the temperature is always about 10 degrees Celsius, whereas in the coldest month, the temperature is always below 18 degrees Celsius, and it is never below minus 3 degrees Celsius. So summers are very warm, whereas winters are mildly cold or sometimes severely cold. And the climate is not extreme. This is because of the maritime influence. We have seen that they are very close to oceans. As a result, they are affected by maritime influence of the ocean winds, that is land and sea breezes. And rainfall in winter is onshore. So when we have seen that westerlies are the winds which are blowing onshore winds, that is they blow from seas to continents. As a result, they can be called as onshore winds. For example, in the January month, that is it is winter, in such a case we have westerlies blowing from oceans to continents to the Mediterranean region. Now these are called as onshore winds or onshore westerlies. They're also called as prevailing westerlies. And one more typical thing here is the rainfall occurs as torrential storms, that is a very quick and sudden outburst of rainfall followed by very clear weather. This is very typical to Mediterranean climate, and this type of feature is not we don't see this type of feature in any other type of climate. So here the rainfall occurs in torrential thunderstorms, and it lasts for only few hours or few days, and then within the next rainfall, the region, the time interval between the next rainfall is totally clear and dry. So we can see the floods are typical to this particular climatic conditions. When it comes to Mediterranean climate, the most important region is the region surrounding the Mediterranean Sea, the Northern Africa, which is to the north of Atlas Mountains, and then we have certain parts of Libya, Algeria, etc., and also we have southern parts of Europe. All these things, all these regions have Mediterranean type of climate, and the most important feature is the local winds, because there are local winds in various other parts of the world, but here they are present in greater numbers. So local winds are the ones which occur only during a particular season or a particular time of a day. So for example, in India we have a wind called Lu. It is an example for a local wind. Likewise, there are many important local winds in the Mediterranean region. For example, we have Mistral, Sirocco, Bora, etc. All these are important local winds which are of regional importance to the Mediterranean region. So Sirocco is a warm wind. It flows from Africa towards the Mediterranean Sea and the southern parts of Europe. It is a very warm and hot wind, so it withers vegetation and crops. It simply means that it completely kills the moisture content in the vegetation. So during extreme summers, because of this wind, the regions in the southern European parts are very warm and dry, and the vegetation is totally devoid of moisture. Sometimes it also brings storms to the Mediterranean Sea, and if there are storms in the Mediterranean Sea, the warmness of this wind is gone, and it becomes comparatively moderate when it reaches the European region, and it brings all the dry dust from the Sahara region, and hence it is called as blood rain because of its red color. We have one more important wind which is called as Mistral. It flows along the Rhone Valley. So this is Rhone Valley, which is present between the Central Massif, which is a plateau in France, and we have Alps on the eastern side, which is in the part of northern Italy. So there is a valley called as Rhone Valley between these two highlands, and this particular valley sees a typical cold wind which is called as Mistral. So this wind can bring very, very cold climatic conditions for this particular region, and this happens in the early spring. And this is a very violent and harmful wind to the region, because it can drop the temperatures to very low conditions, also bringing blizzards and various other adverse weather phenomena. And other similar winds are called as tremontane, gregal, etc., which are all typical to the Mediterranean region. Coming to natural vegetation, here the trees are short, they're not so very tall, and they have very small broad leaves. This is mainly because they have to conserve water, where water is lost in the form of transpiration. If you have very wide area of leaves, due to shortness of or short size of leaves, the transpiration is checked, especially during the dry season of summer. And they are very widely spaced, as we have seen that this particular region is dry for a very long time. Only winters have some amount of rainfall. As a result, they have to compete, all the trees have to compete for water. So they are very widely spaced so that there is no severe competition among the trees for water. And absence of shade is one distinct feature. This is because of widely scattered trees in the region, and plants are in continuous struggle for especially moisture. And most of the vegetation is xerophytic, which is nothing but drought tolerant kind of vegetation. In desert type, we have seen there are varieties like cactus and various other aloe vera and various other similar xerophytic vegetation, and such vegetation is also found in Mediterranean climatic regions as well. So certain areas are typical to Mediterranean climate. For example, the giant redwood tree forest in California is one example of this kind of Mediterranean climate, and this is an exception. For example, we have very short trees, especially in the Mediterranean region, whereas when it comes to Mediterranean climate in California, here the redwood trees in California, which is one of the few of the tallest trees in the world, are present in the Californian region, which is a form of Mediterranean climate. And some trees are evergreen coniferous trees, and they are a kind of transition type between the Mediterranean climate and the northernmost taiga type of climate. And the bushes and shrubs, which are mostly xerophytic, are most common in this particular region. So the giant redwood tree, they attain a height of about 100 meters in the Californian region, there are few trees which are well over 100 meters. So these are the tallest trees in the world. Coming to other typical vegetation type, here the evergreen oaks are the most characteristic vegetation of the Mediterranean climate. So these are the trees which are not so tall, and they are very widely scattered. They don't occur in very close proximity because of competition for water and various other natural resources. And these type of evergreen oaks occurs only in regions where there are favorable climatic conditions, like a significant amount of rainfall. And when it comes to other dry regions of the Mediterranean climate, usually xerophytic vegetation dominates. And usually the dry regions have trees with massive trunks. This is because they have to store water for the dry season. And we know that all the dry regions have to conserve water from where the loss of water occurs due to transpiration. And to avoid transpiration, the trees here have evolved with small leathery leaves. So leathery leaves doesn't facilitate transpiration, especially in the summer season. And they are widely spreading roots in the search of water. And one important thing is the cork oaks, where we have bottle corks, or we have like the cork is nothing but the one which is placed on the wine bottle or any other bottle as a cap. So these particular corks are very good, and they are mainly obtained from the cork or evergreen oaks. So the wood from evergreen oaks is used for making corks. So in Australia, the evergreen oaks is replaced by the eucalyptus forest, and eucalyptus forest is a kind of a lumbering industry in the eastern Australian region. Mediterranean climatic region of Australia, which occurs on the western side of the Australian landmass. Coming to grasses, this is one important feature which completely discourages cattle rearing or pasturing or any other form of cattle rearing industry. So here the problem with the grasses is they are not nutritious. They are wiry and bunchy, that is, they are lean and tough. When it comes to bunchy, they are very closely spaced and they are very rough, and they cannot be grazed by the animals. And again, this is one important feature which separates Mediterranean climate from the steppe type of climate. We have seen about steppe type of climate in the previous video, where the steppe type of climate is the leading animal rearing or livestock industry in the world because of various favorable conditions, like the nutritious grasses, and in some regions there is fertile soils. So all these factors aid the livestock industry, whereas in the Mediterranean region there are various climatic conditions which totally discourage cattle rearing industry. This is because of the long dry season of summer, where the growth of grass is not good because of the lack of rains. Whereas in winters, the cold climate hinders the development of grasses, and due to good amount of rainfall that occurs only in winter is totally nullified by the winter climatic conditions like extreme coldness. So as a result, the grasses don't grow in both winter as well as summer, or they don't develop or evolve in both the seasons. As a result, the grasses here are not nutritious. As a result, it is a net importer of various dairy products. So one dominant occupation in the Mediterranean climate is the cultivation of fruits, especially the citrus fruits. So like there are various conditions, weather conditions, which discourage the growth of grasses. Likewise, there are some weather conditions or the weather conditions of the Mediterranean climate which totally facilitates the growth of citrus fruits and various other fruits. This is because of long summers. And during summers, the fruits ripen quickly due to warmness. And during winters, it is growing season for the trees, and they have good amount of water. As a result, they grow well in the winters. And during summers, they totally ripen. And this type of climatic conditions support the industry of fruit production. And we know that Mediterranean climate is one of the leading exporters of fruits, whereas it is leading importers of dairy products. And 70% of the world's exports of citrus fruits happens from this region. Israel is one important producer of fruits. So Israel being a country with a lot of topographical challenges, along with a very less fertile soil, but still it leads in the fruit cultivation because of the favorable weather conditions of the Mediterranean climate and use of technology. Other important thing here is the olive tree, which is most typical to the Mediterranean climate. It is almost absent in other types of climatic regions. So most of the cooking oil is obtained from the olive oil. We know that here the animal growth is, or livestock feeding is discouraged. As a result, there is no availability of animal fat in the form of cheese, ghee, etc. And here the crops are the olives or citrus kind of crops, and there are oil seeds and other crops are absent. As a result, the cooking oil is chiefly obtained from the olive trees. And wherever there is good fertile soils, then we see the cultivation of wheat and barley. This is the chief cereal crop of Mediterranean climate. And in some regions where there are pastures, especially in the highlands, we see the grazing of goats and sheep. So this is very few cattle or goats or sheep available in such favorable regions like the mountain pastures. And transhumance is widely practiced. This is nothing but taking these cattle to the pasture lands during favorable seasons and bringing back during unfavorable seasons. This kind of practice is called as transhumance. For example, in the hilly regions during winters, the mountain tops are capped by snow. As a result, the pasturing is not an option. Hence, the cattle herders migrate to the south. And during summers, when the snow is clear, they take the goat to the top of the mountainous regions where the grass is free of snow, and they get the cattle to graze over the top of the mountain or highland regions. So this particular practice is called as transhumance. And one of the important occupations of Mediterranean climate is viticulture. Viticulture is nothing but wine production. And we know that most of the wine is obtained from grapes. So grapes is a kind of citrus fruit which grows very well in the Mediterranean climatic region. The most important climatic factor that enables the good cultivation of grapes is the long sunny summers, which allows for the ripening of grapes. Coming to the economy, the other important occupation is tourism. So most of the regions in the Mediterranean region, especially in this particular region, that is the region around the Mediterranean Sea, has a lot of historical places, because Roman Empire and certain empires in Greece have all come up in this particular region. As a result, this place is very important tourist destination. Let us look at a question on Mediterranean climate. A geographic region has the following distinct characteristics: warm and dry climate, mild and wet winters, evergreen oak trees. So till now we have studied that Mediterranean is the only region which has which has dry summers, and the winters are wet because of abundant rainfall. And evergreen oak trees are very chief characteristic of Mediterranean type of climate. Coming to warm and dry type of climate, there are different warm and dry type of climates. For example, Indian monsoon type of climate is also a warm and dry type of climate. And we have savanna type of climate, which is also a warm and dry type of climate. In both these types of climates, we have rainfall occurring mostly in the summer season and winters are dry. Whereas in the Mediterranean climate, we have winters which are wet and summers which are dry. So even Mediterranean climate can be called as a warm and dry type of climate. So mild and wet winters, here's if you look at the options, this is somewhat confusing because it applies for a lot of various other climatic regions. And this is also somewhat confusing because this also occurs to two various climatic regions. But evergreen oak trees is a very strong characteristics of Mediterranean climate. And if you check the options, so in the next videos we'll study about Eastern China type of climate, and we know that Central Asia is affected by steppe type of climate. In steppe type of climate, we don't have we don't see oak trees. It is totally treeless. Here we only have grasses in the steppe type of climatic region. And we have Atlantic coast of North America. So Atlantic coast of North America, here the climate is called as Laurentian type of climate, and this occurs in the eastern margins. So this type of climate has rainfall all the year round. As a result, this is not a mild and wet. This doesn't fit under the option of warm and dry type of climate here, because there is no distinct dry season. As a result, all these options can be ruled out. And the evergreen oaks itself says that it is the Mediterranean type of climate. And there is local variation of Mediterranean type of climate. It is called as CSB, which is cool summer Mediterranean climate, and this is confined to very few regions like the northwestern Iberia, which is part of Spain, and we have coastal California surrounding the Californian region, which sees the Mediterranean type of climate, and there are certain other parts like central Chile, and all these are transitions between the Mediterranean climate and the surrounding climates. So the typical feature is here the rainfall is comparatively better compared to the Mediterranean climate, and there is the oceanic influence is very, very significant. So coming to the climatic graphs, so here we can see we have two regions. One is San Francisco, which is in the northern hemisphere, and Cape Town, which is a part of southern hemisphere. Both these regions have Mediterranean type of climate. So Cape Town is not totally Mediterranean type. It is a kind of, we have seen in the previous thing, that is cool summer Mediterranean type of climate. So here we can see there is no distinct or very significant dry season because of the oceanic influence, but still it has winter maxima. We know that in summer, southern hemisphere, we have winter in the June and July months. As a result, we can see the rainfall is highest in the June and July months, and this is typical to the Mediterranean type of climate. Whereas in the northern hemisphere, here the oceanic influence is low. As a result, the summer months are totally dry. Summer months are totally dry, and winters have peak amount of rainfall. So this is typical to Mediterranean type of climate. Usually these type of graphs are shown in the prelims exam, and you are asked to identify the climatic region. So please keep an eye on these type of graphs. So this is all about Mediterranean type of climate, and if you like my video, don't forget to subscribe to my channel, and thanks for watching.